everyone. Today I wanted to share with y'all a project that I've been working on. I've been working on our little entryway area. This area has taken me the longest to figure out. I wanted it to be functional but still cute. I know you've heard me complain 1,000 times about how dark our apartment gets, so this area was by far the darkest and I wanted to brighten it up a little bit. So first and foremost, I decided to paint it white and I chose this gorgeous color. It's Alabaster by Sherwin-Williams. It's a nice warm white, so I thought that that would be the perfect color. Now you all know I'm super short, I'm only 5'1", so I got this super handy tool. It's basically an extendable roller and you can put as many pieces as you'd like together to make it as long as you need. It was perfect for me to reach all the high spots without having to hop on and off a chair. So I would highly recommend this if you are short and painting anything in your home. With the magic of editing, we go from this boring beige to a nice warm white. The next thing I wanted to do to add a little bit of personality to this area was create a faux shiplap wall. I used a meter stick and a level and I measured out every 5.5 inches, which later I realized that I have a laser level, so I probably could have used that, but a meter stick and a regular level work just fine if you don't have a laser level. I've seen this project done before with Sharpies and I actually tried it for myself, but the Sharpie lines look so fake. So I actually found that with the black color pencil, they looked much more realistic. And I will warn you, it does smudge a little bit, so I wouldn't put this in an area that's very high traffic or if you have kids that are going to be touching the walls. But just to be safe, I did seal some of the areas, especially that like close to the light switches or near the door frame where we might lean on the wall. I sealed it with a little bit of hairspray, but I'm sure that you can also use like a poly sealer or something else if you do want to fully seal the wall. It looks great from far away, obviously, but it also looks very good even close up. I had friends that came to visit and they didn't even realize that it wasn't fake. So it really does hold up. Now to add a little bit of storage, I bought this gorgeous cabinet from TJ Maxx. I really do love the look of modern pieces mixed with some like vintage and old pieces, so I thought that that would be perfect. I've been wanting to add a little gallery wall somewhere in our apartment, so I thought that this would be the perfect spot for that. I used some pieces that I had already collected and thrifted in the past, and then I bought some new frames that I gave a bit of a makeover to add to our gallery wall. So first I had this artwork that I found at a Goodwill once, and I just wanted the frame to be black, so I gave it a quick little spray paint. I love this chalked spray paint because it has a very matte finish, and I chose the charcoal color so it wouldn't be a very stark black. Then I found this frame at Hobby Lobby, which I thought was so cute, but it wouldn't match the rest of the gallery wall, so I gave it a quick little makeover with the spray paint as well. Now for the art pieces, I had a couple frames that were empty that I needed art for. If you're ever at the thrift store, definitely check the art books. There are a lot of books that are, for example, from museum galleries and things like that that have prints of famous artwork, and that's the perfect way to get prints for very cheap. I think each of these books I paid $1 for, and I got a bunch of prints out of them. You basically just rip the page that has the print that you like, you cut it to fit your frame, and then this is completely optional, but I love to use matte Mod Podge on them so that they look like faux oil paintings. Thank you. I couldn't finish the whole gallery wall because I was still waiting for a couple of things to arrive, so that just goes to show you that projects take time. I think I did this project over a week.
Perfect.
When everything finally arrived, I placed the last couple of pieces on the wall, and then it was just time to decorate. I got this beautiful paper mache bowl, which you probably saw in my haul video, and that's where we're storing our keys and our wallets. And then I just added a couple of books and this gorgeous marble chain. And that was basically it. So now here is the before. A very boring, very dark, sad area. Not very practical and just kind of sad seeing that when you first walk in. And the after. I absolutely love how it turned out. The faux shiplap makes it feel like it's a cottage or a farmhouse somewhere instead of a new build apartment. And I love seeing how my new pieces go together with my DIYs and my thrifted pieces. I've been trying to add little personal touches to my home here and there. So on the gallery wall, we have my family's empanada recipe, a Coca-Cola can opener, because if you know me, you know that I am addicted to Coca-Cola, and a little vintage style print of Loki that I made. And while I love how our little entryway looks now, I'm always itching for change, and I'm already considering maybe adding a rug here or adding more pieces to the gallery wall and building up on it. But let me know in the comments below what you think of the makeover. If you like this video, definitely drop a like, that really helps me out. And don't forget to subscribe for more renter-friendly projects. I will see you all very soon in another video. Bye!